Hello, 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 hello. Hello. Welcome back today again to the Xbox version of Space Engineers. And I was on the official Discord, or the unofficial Discord for our Facebook group. Or the official Discord for our Facebook group, I should say. And our group being the unofficial Xbox group for Space Engineers. And I said, if I hit 950 subscribers today, I would talk about my solar tracking array that uses no scripts. It also doesn't use the gyroscope method. It can be built fairly simply using two rotors and a hinge. This is the sun. Viewed through a camera. You'll see very, very carefully. If you continue to watch to the left of the sun, the stars on the skybox are moving very slowly. You can see this if you put something like a mountain on the left-hand side. Watch it carefully for a bit. That mountain means that the solar array is slowly moving to follow the sun. Now, this is a trick. It only works if you're on vanilla time. If you leave the time setting exactly as it is in the game normally. How's it done? Well, here's one prepared earlier. I'm using the high-tech solar arrays as well. They're pretty cool. Basically, all you need is a base. You don't have to build it like I did. Let's grind this out. Even though we're in creative, I prefer to grind things away. Right, there we go. There, and... Right! All the parts needed. A base. A rotor. A command control station, so you can actually use it to set your array up. A battery, if you want to store some power. Which you can also use to set your array up. And what you need to know is that your rotors, you have a hinge which controls the pitch, the up and down of your solar array, and you have a rotor which is lower to turn the solar array, and then what I've called the sun tracker, which is your other rotor, which is the one that stays on a constant speed. And this works because the speed of the sun in Space Engineers vanilla is this, 0.0083 on the velocity. Now you can enter that exactly by pressing A twice on your velocity settings and typing the number in, even on a controller. It essentially works simply, if you want to build a really simple one, all you'd need is a rotor, a block, a rotor, a hinge on top of that, and then your array. So it could literally just be some blocks, a solar panel, and a camera. Why the camera? Well, on your control panel, when you're setting up this particular thing, you want some controls. So, first of all, we look at the hinge. We want the hinge lock on and off on the down direction. And we want hinge reverse on the up direction. We want the rotor lower turn reverse to the left and rotor lock to the right. Why do we want that? Well, if we move on to the second page by holding down left stick, tapping B, you'll see we've got some other controls. We've got my merge block, which we can use to connect this array to a base, or even make another merge block and stick a connector on it. We've got a camera. That camera is why we are here in this particular setup. If you look, this particular array is following the sun, but it's very, very slightly out. So why do we have our particular camera? It's so we can set up this. So if we're in camera view, we can use the hinges by turning the hinge lock off. We can change the direction of the hinge and move it up and down. Lock it in place when we're happy. The same deal for the rotor. Going the wrong way, tap the left direction. Wait until the sun is almost central to the camera screen. A little bit of fiddling. Adjust it. There it goes. You have your rotor lock on the second page for our sun tracker. And the same deal, we have reverse. So if we're looking the wrong way when we zoom into the stars and we see things aren't quite moving correctly, which they are at the moment, we can quickly change that and change the rotation on the rotor without having to go into the control panel and change its direction. If we went into the control panel, you can see that my rotor lower turn is set up normally. Its upper and lower limits are unlimited. Its velocity is at minus one because it's moving in this particular orientation. And you haven't really got to worry about that. If we look at our sun tracker, you'll see that our sun tracker is set at 0.01 RPM. It's actually not set to 0.01. It is set to 0.0083. Its displacement is important. As with the other rotor, set your displacement to maximum, the same as the lower turn rotor needs to be set to maximum. Because if you build any decorative blocks around it to make it look pretty, like I've done, you'll actually lock the rotor in place and damage the whole thing. So always make sure that your rotor displacement is as high as possible when you're building this. Finally, the hinge on the up and down. I've put a lot of torque and braking torque because we're in gravity, a velocity of 1, a lower limit of minus 45, and an upper limit of 0. When you look on hinges, you'll see that there is actually a little bar on the hinge. I've covered this in the hinge tutorial, but that's your lower limit, and that's set to 45 degrees. And that's about right for catching the sun in my fly swatter looking array. Remember, as long as you build this array so you can have a camera to point at the sun to help you orientate it, it will continuously move like this one over here throughout the day, tracking that sun across the sky. As the sun starts to go down, it will continue to move. And when the sun comes up in the morning, that array will be facing the direction the sun rises, and it will give you full power during the day. Remember, you get nothing at night. And that is the essence of these arrays. A block a rotor, some more blocks, a rotor, a hinge, and your array. The hinge set with a lower limit of minus 45 and an upper limit of 0. This rotor, nothing changes apart from having a higher displacement. And also, that's your sun tracking rotor. So that one needs a velocity set to 0.0083. Leave that on the screen in a minute. It will also be in the description as well. And once that rotor is set at that velocity, you can just let it run. I've put shear inertia tensor on my rotors as well to stop any potential clang. And that is, in essence, how to build a no-script, no-gyroscope solar tracker that relies on knowing the movement, or as close as you can get it, speed of the sun. 0.0083. I've got 80 there because I'm testing various speeds, but 83 is fairly accurate. I've had an entire day and night of watching this cycle, and it works fine. So we just look at this again. Remember to put your camera on the second page. Put your sun tracker reverse at the top. Sun tracker rotor lock on off at the bottom. Merge block if you build one to the right. Camera to the left. Page one. Hinge up and down on reverse at the top. Lock on and off at the bottom. Rotor lower turn on and off lock on the right, and the rotor lower turn reverse on the left. Reach out to me on YouTube if you have any questions regarding this, or you want to ask me any questions in general. We are moving over, hopefully, 950 subscribers, heading towards 1,000. And at 1,000, something is going to happen. Something interesting with the aid of my good friend, Paul Thompson, who creates such wondrous constructions in this game, the likes of which many have never seen. His Temple of Clang is incredible. Paul is building a JAEGER from Pacific Rim. I'm going to link to Paul's channel and his video where he's put up a few JAEGER tests. And what he's going to do is, once he's finished the build and I hit 1,000 subscribers, one of my subscribers will get to name the build before the build is released. And the build itself will be released to subscribers of this channel. And if you've not seen his JAEGER yet, you're in for a treat. This thing is a work of art. I've not seen really anything built in Space Engineers the likes of this. I'll leave all that information at the end of the video and in the description. I'll link Paul's channel, although you can get to it through my channels at the bottom. That really is all I could say about the solar tracker. You can build it how you want, as long as you follow the steps of having a rotor, a block, a rotor, a hinge, a block, the array, and a camera to align the array, and just let it run. Get a bunch of them, all aim them at the sun, let them go, and you have a solar panel power farm that will accurately track the sun near as nothing throughout the whole day. And it will continue to turn at night due to the residual energy from the battery. If you're worried about it not turning, you could always attach a wind turbine. It only has to be residual energy, so you could just pop a block out here like this, pop another block in. Pop it away. Just leave it to turn. Because on an Earth like, or any planet with wind, that's your best power source right there. And as a refresher for that, remember, the lower they are, the less power they generate. The closer they are to each other, the less power they generate. So you want to put them up about 12 to 13 blocks high, come down a block and build a tower of 5. And since we hit 950, I'll briefly show you this in action. So let's go up about 13 or so blocks, come round 1, 2, 3. Oh. Build a turbine on the top. And then go round like this and build your turbines. Right. Now, we may get less than optimal on this due to the fact that we are in a valley on the ice lake. But that is the tower of turbines. And as long as you build those far enough away from each other and link them into your base, you can make a pretty effective power system just using turbines. Pop a control panel there. Optimal. There you go. So not only did you get a solar panel tracker tutorial out of this one, but you also got my quick tower of turbines that a lot of people use because they're so useful. That's it. That's really all I can say about the solar tracker with no scripts, no gyros, just a rotor, a hinge, and the speed of the sun in vanilla. It won't work if you're not running vanilla settings. You need to know the speed of the sun at any other setting to be able to make this work. That's it. I'm going to say bye for now. I'll catch you in the next one as we steamroll towards 1,000 and wow, that's all I'll say. Nearly a year's worth of Space Engineers content as of the 27th of April this year. And I'm so glad I'm still here to be able to do it. I'm recovering from this horrible virus and I seem to be getting better. Bye for now.